Hey, what's up, YouTubers? It's Keith here again making another video. It's been a while since I made one. Like I said before, my family's back, so it's kind of chaotic in the house. As you can see, I'm clean shaven because I was off of work for some time for an injury related to work. And so now I'm going to be going back to work, and where I work, we can't have facial hair and blase, blase. But the reason why I'm making this video is to address two things. And the first and foremost thing, because I'm freaking pissed off, is this TERRAL03. Now, if you guys know who he is, and if you guys are followers of his, then you might want to listen up. Mike over at Patriotic Space has made a video about what he's doing and his agenda. Another gal, her name, she goes by Thy Always Seek. She has a page here on YouTube as well. But basically what it is this. This cat, TERRAL03, has got this movement and these people who are, hold on, my daughter's just, okay, go lay down, okay? Hold on, let me put them back and I'll come right back. All right, sorry guys, it's, you know, my daughters came in, you know, their mother's out doing ballet right now, so I'm trying to get this out quick. But what I was saying before is this TERRAL03, a couple of people are making video responses because they're beginning to wake up to what he's doing. And what he's doing is he's getting these groups to go to these Ozarks. Now, although at first glimpse, because I'm not a subscriber to him, because from the get-go, I just got this feeling, you know. But the point is this, is what he's doing is he's basically kind of like televising through via YouTube of these groups that he's putting together. And what he's doing is, I mean, if you listen to watch his videos, I mean, he sounds like a chauvinistic pig is what he sounds like. And he sounds like a fear-mongering individual. And he's talking about people in these groups, they should have deep pockets and large people who with money. Well, if this guy knows anything about anything, he would know that money doesn't mean anything. When all this shit hits the fan, the U.S. dollar has already lost its value. I mean, it's almost done. It's going to be done. And then when all this, after this catastrophe and all this stuff happens, they're going to bring in the Amero. They're going to do the North American Union. So money, and he's barking up the wrong tree. He doesn't sound real is what he's doing. But I'm making this to everybody who subscribed to me. Thank you guys for subscribing to me, giving me the positive feedback. I appreciate it, you guys, as always. Like I said, I'm doing these videos for you guys. I'm doing these videos for you guys. And people on YouTube, we're all doing the same thing. None of us that I know of in my immediate circle of subscribers and people who I'm subscribed to, they're not doctors, they're not astrologists, they're not neurologists, they're not politicians. These people are people like you and I who go on YouTube to get the real news and the real media. With that being said, every video that's on YouTube isn't put out by people who do extensive research like the vast majority of people that I'm subscribed to or that I know about, people who are going by facts. But you got to kind of weed out the bullshit, if you will. Excuse my language. But you got to be cautious about who you view and what you get your energy and what you get wrapped up into. Because with that being said, there's people who will mislead you. YouTube is infiltrated with the same people who want nothing but the worst for you, who don't give a crap about you. Now, this is a perfect network where, I mean, literally anybody can have an account on YouTube. Anybody. With good intentions, ill intentions, whatever the case may be, YouTube doesn't discriminate, okay, as far as who can have a page and who can put up videos, as long as your content and stuff remains in a certain bracket, you know what I mean, for YouTube viewers. But with that being said, if you can come to the realization that our government and our world, just society as itself, has been infiltrated by people who are working for dark entities and who are the puppeteers to the puppets, and who want to get a inside scoop on the very everything. I mean, why wouldn't they stop at YouTube? Do you know what I'm saying? So you gotta be cautious and tiptoe around who has the facts. That's why I always urge every one of my viewers and subscribers to do your own research. But as far as TERRAL03, I'll tell you one thing. Do not go off of what he says. I mean, although he sounds like good intentions, you don't want to be a part of a group that already is telling you. They're not even a formed group yet. They don't even know each other. But he's welcoming all these people with heavy-duty, you know, defense weapons and assault rifles and people. And he's already saying that there's going to be structure and get out of line. Well, Patriotic, Michael Red Patriotic said, well, what's getting out of line? Because what that means is just you're setting up rules and a kind of a system of there has to be this order, and if not, well, that's all based on opinions. Getting out of line is based in opinions. What you say you're getting out of line, and someone else might say, no, he's not, but you're going to handle it. That's what I'm saying. You got to be cautious around people who take this dictatorship type of role. You want to get with people who are like-minded. You don't want to just jump in any survival group because everybody wants to survive. But if you're in a group that will do anything to survive, meaning they don't give a shit about you, they will steal from you, or when you're sick and maimed, they will take what they want. So you need to be cautious because this cat seems like one of those guys. Like Mike said, the general from the Postman, Kevin Costner movie, that was the end of time scenario. Not really, but it's kind of like that. There was a huge change in the way that the U.S. was run. And this general took this position of this, you know, this guy who's just out there and not necessarily crazy, but a person that can move people with words into doing what he wants. And so you need to be cautious of people like that. Stick with people who have love, man. Stick with people who have love. Because even though you want to hate everybody and be so hurt and pissed off that people are doing this to you, you have to love thy neighbor. You know what I mean? Turn the other cheek. You know what I mean? This is just life, man. It's just life. This is a roller coaster of life, man. It's just one big trip. But how you go through it is going to change whatever else follows. So, you know what I mean? People like I said before, that want anger and revulsion and stuff like that. I don't want to be part of that, man. I'd rather be trying to, you know, live, you know, day by day, you know. And yeah, no one wants to struggle, but I'd rather struggle with my family than struggle with a group that what they're doing and a lot of things they believe in, I don't believe in. I'm not expecting everybody and anybody to believe in just what I believe in. Hell no. Like, there's a movie out there on YouTube that I just watched. If you guys go to my channel, it's in my favorites list. It's called Esoteric, something like that, Agenda, the full-length movie. Just go on my favorites. I think it's like the latest one I added to my favorites. That one is a very good movie because it talks about leadership. And if a good leader will educate people with what they know, but will then tell them to not follow them, you know, to follow, become leaders. So a good leader makes good leaders. But you have to remember that in order to be a good leader, you first have to be a good follower. No one's born a good leader. So if you can't follow and learn, you'll never be a good leader at all. So take everything you're pulling from YouTube and whatever you guys download next or view next, be cautious. Take in everything as information and opinions, but don't take it as concrete plans to do something. Now, preparation is always a must. Always be prepared. But with everything said and done, we don't know what's going to happen. Something's coming. Something is coming. You know, all this flooding and shit out there in the Midwest. Man, all of us that are watching this, I guarantee you probably aren't those people. Because we're looking up shit that doesn't matter. Those people don't even have internet.
Hey, you guys, I got cut off again. And then I started recording again, and I lost the whole video. Ah! Hate that, but... and I was on a good one, too. I was rolling. But... Anyways, what I was saying was about this flooding and stuff like that. That stuff's going to just become a domino effect and create this tsunami inland, on land. You know, this, because when the snow melts and that water and with all the rain that keeps coming, it's just gonna be this huge tsunami. I mean, it's just going to just boom, boom, and those dams aren't going to hold. So those people, what I was saying is that, like, people like you and I that are watching this and that are looking up stuff like this, say a prayer for those that are in that area, man, because it's not at our front door. You know what I mean? But those people are, you know, they're whether they're good people or whether they're bad people, they're people in general, you know. Like there's a saying, you know, the rain falls on good people and bad people. So, you know, pray for all those people, you guys, or say a chant or whatever your religion is, but give some time to focus and, you know, give them a little bit of our energy, because man, those people, they need it. And you know, soon we'll all be in that world of hurt soon enough. We'll all be affected, and we will be. But I want to get back on track. I want to cut this guy short, you guys, because I just ramble on and on and on. And if you've seen my videos before, and if you're a subscriber to me, then you probably won't mind, but I'm not a crazy man, you know what I'm saying? I try and touch bases on a broad scale in such a short period of time. But I want to get back to the survival groups, TERRAL03 and his agenda, and all these people worldwide that are following his lead. I want you guys to educate yourself on what's happening as far as the current events, the real current events, all the volcanoes and earthquakes and this flooding and all these nuclear bases here in U.S. soil that's, you know, being submerged, and the stuff that's facts, not just opinions, but I mean straight up facts, because this conspiracy theory that people talked about, it doesn't sound crazy anymore. It's not even conspiracy. This shit is really happening right now. So we are in the time of, I mean, catastrophic change on so many different levels. But if you're going to get in a group and follow TERRAL03, because I'm not going to sit here and tell you what to do. But just, you need to be cautious, because when you're in a group with people who you don't know, that who are already setting up this kind of like dictatorship and kind of like this system of how it's going to be, because no one knows how it's going to be. I mean, I'll tell you one thing right now. If you were ever in the military, or you know someone else was in the military, and you come to a new unit, and you've never been to the field before with them for a training exercise or what have you, you really see how people really are when you're out in the bush for a month, 2 months, 3 months, or when you go on a combat deployment to Iraq or Afghanistan or wherever you are. Boy, you see how people really act. Because there is, at the end of it, you don't just go home at the end of the day. You don't leave your stress at the office. You know what I mean? When you're in a survivor group, that becomes a brotherhood and a sisterhood. But you have to work together as a team and have a understanding that you guys are, you know, in to survive. But if you follow groups like TERRAL03 and go in these Ozarks, first of all, it's no mystery now. Everybody who goes on YouTube can find out where these Ozarks are and who's going. And it's like, YouTube is no safe haven for a network to be free from the people who we're speaking out against, that who want you know to destroy you. I mean, you're giving out call signs, and it's no mystery. Okay, they're gonna be there. I mean, so it's intelligence that you're not keeping secret. I mean, that's just stupid. That's just stupid, you know. But you want us to be cautious if you're going to follow guys like TERRAL03, because there will be another guy or gal or whatever the case may be. But you need to be cautious, because if you get in a group that people are armed and have
anger and will do anything to survive. Meaning they'll steal, kill, and rob you to survive. Now, by saying that, I'm saying if you join a group like that and then you find out that, damn, you know, these guys really aren't on the same page as I, and I'm not on the same page as them, and I don't agree with how they're running things and how they view stuff. And you know what? You go to try and leave. You say, you know what, you guys? I'm just going to take my family and we're going to go and try and survive on our own. Well, guess what? It'll be too late. Because they'll be armed and they'll outnumber you and say, well, you know what? No, you're not. You want to leave? Fine. But we're taking your weapons. We're taking your rations. We're taking the clothes off your back. If you want to leave, go ahead. Then it's too late. You know, so be cautious, man. But the most important thing above all is to have self-reliance, to educate yourself, not on all the corruption, and don't waste your time on all this shit, you guys. Study survival. Because I'll tell you one thing right now, even by studying survival and how to live out in the wild, in the bush, educate as much as you can about how to eat wild edibles, how to preserve water, how to ration water, how to ration your food, how to address first aid and medical attention out in the bush, out in the desert, out in the mountains, or whatever. Even though that's what you all should be educating yourself on. Go on the YouTubers like Wilderness Outfitters and Baron Bushcraft, and there's a bunch of different sites out there that on YouTube, that guys that are educational videos that are free. That's what you should be spending your time in. But not, I mean, we all know it's corrupted and it's going to get exposed, but we have very little time to get as much education we can on surviving. That's what you should be putting your energy towards. Because if you have to pick up in Didi Mao and go and head for the hills or the mountains or wherever you're going, even if you're going to go to the Ozarks, you better learn how to survive so that you could become, you're not codependent. You have self-reliance and you don't have to depend on anybody. Of course, when you're with a group of people, you want to get with a group of like-minded individuals and people who are educated in survival tactics and different stuff like that. But you don't want to be completely lost if you may lose them or they die or whatever the case may be. So you have to have self-reliance and educate yourself. But, you know, as any survivalist, it will tell you, if you have the motivation and drive to survive, you will improvise, you know. But you will learn as you go is what I'm saying. But as far as Terral and all those Ozark and all these groups like that, boy, you're going to take a gamble. You're going to take a very big, very, very big gamble. So, you know, I'm going to close this up because I don't want to ramble on too much. But do your education, you guys. Do your study. And like this guy, Terral03, he's got a donation button, or he's asking for money. You need to stay away from anybody who does that, because we're all hurting, man. We're all hurting, and it's going to get harder and harder and harder. But I promise you guys this. I will never, ever ask a dime from any of you viewers. Because for what? For what? Don't ask for money. I mean, all these people who are giving educational and using YouTube for that, they're not asking for money. And those that who are, who do they think they are? You know? If you're making videos, it's for people to appreciate and to utilize as knowledge. Not so you can pay your car payment or buy your survival gear. Because we're all hurting, man. We're all hurting. So let's stick in it together. But educate yourself on survival tactics and utilizing natural resources. Okay? Use your time to do that and energy to do that. Because we already know the Illuminati and the evil and the Gregorian and all this stuff exists. And it's very vibrant today. But the more you give that energy to studying that, it's taken away from your energy and your focus from what's really going to matter. Because, you know, when you're behind bars or in a FEMA camp and you're like telling everybody, oh yeah, and they do this, you're in the FEMA camp. It doesn't matter at that point how much you know about the Illuminati, because they got you where they want you. So you're going to die with useless knowledge. And that's basically what it is. So educate yourself, guys, with very good knowledge on how to survive. But always keep in mind of this. If there is an NBC, nuclear, biological, or chemical attack on our land, which there probably will be. And, you know, if it happens, there's nuclear plants, going underwater right now as we speak. So even though you get survival tactics, and you got to know that you can't depend on gardens that you grow, because you can't wash out nuclear material. You can't do it, you guys. So educate yourself as much as you can. And remember, you know, educate, knowledge is key, you guys. Don't become a follower of people like TERRAL03. They will, like I said before in my last video, you can lead a sheep to its own slaughter. So, you know, be cautious, you guys. And my prayers are going out to all you guys out there in the area of Midwest. I'm in Cali, California. So, but, you know, we're going to all be affected. But my thoughts and prayer goes out to you guys. And, you know, if you guys are viewing this, you know, keep them in your thoughts. You know, at least give them that bit of energy, because, you know, it shit hits the fan real quick. You know, Comet Elenin or Planet X or whatever that's predicted to come in the near future, there's shit happening right now that's affecting people devastatingly. So, you know, people are already at wit's end. They are already in their world. You know, the end of the world in retrospect is already at their front door. So people are having a rough, man, and it's gonna come to you. And when it does, just be calm, man. Just be calm, keep love, keep your sanity, keep your morals, and always remember, you guys, it doesn't matter what happens around you, but what matters is what happens within you. Remember that, and you'll be golden pony boy. Alright? I love you guys, take care, and, you know, be cautious. Be cautious.